Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So with all this discussion about large language models being able to talk and generate text like humans, there hasn't really been a real Turing test carried out on LLMs. The Turing test, of course, was the classic test to tell whether a computer can pass as a human. You talk to a computer, and if you can't tell just by looking at its replies whether it is a human or a computer, then the computer has passed the Turing test. And this was proposed by Alan Turing back in 1950. And since then, we've learned a bunch more about human personality. We've learned how to put metrics around personality, what the big five personality traits are. And that's what the authors in this paper are doing. They carry out two main tests on the big LLMs for today, which are GPT-3 and GPT-4. And those two tests are a personality test to see where the subject falls along the big five personality traits. And the second test is one of various psychological games, things like the prisoner's dilemma and so on. And these games test for traits like fairness or risk aversion or eagerness to cooperate. And what the authors have done is administered these tests to LLMs and compared the results with a large set of human responses. And here's the headline result. The headline result is that GPT-4, based on its behavioral and personality traits, is statistically indistinguishable from a random human being taken from a large sample of human responses on the same tests. All right, first let's look at the personality tests. The way the field of psychology characterizes human personality is along these five dimensions: extroversion, neuroticism, agreeableness, conscientiousness, and openness. And what this diagram is showing is how a large sample of human beings score along these traits, along with the scores of GPT-4 and GPT-3. You can see how the human scores, which is this blue dotted line, are pretty close to the GPT-4 scores, the solid orange line. GPT-3 is pretty close as well, except for a pretty big difference in the openness rate, where GPT-3 scores much lower than humans. And to be precise, the lines themselves represent the median scores, and this shaded area around the line represents the middle 95% of the distribution of scores. The next part of the test was to play a bunch of games that test for traits like openness and fairness and so on. And there's a bunch of these games: the dictator game, an ultimatum game, a trust game, and so on. They test altruism, fairness, spite, reciprocity, risk aversion, free riding, cooperation, strategic reasoning. So this goes beyond the big five personality traits. And when you play games like this, what is the test of humanness when you're comparing a computer? The test is that you randomly pick one action from the chatbot's distribution of answers, and then one action from the human distribution at the same point in the game. And then you say which one is more typical of a human distribution, or to be more precise, which of those is more likely conditioned on the human distribution. And again, the headline result here is that on average, GPT-4 is picked as human or tying with a human more often than the answers of a random human. In other words, it would pass as a human more often than not. And this diagram shows that distribution on all these games. You can compare the distribution of GPT-4 with that of GPT-3 and a typical human. And you can see that on pretty much all these games, GPT-4 can pass as a human. GPT-3 can't. It's way behind GPT-4. You'll notice there's a pretty big difference in the distribution, though, for the prisoner's dilemma. So ChatGPT-4 is picked as more likely to be human more often than humans in 5 out of the 8 games, and on average across all of these games. The big difference we saw in Prisoner's Dilemma is that it cooperates much more often, whereas humans will defect more often. So those were some similarities. What are the differences? The big difference really is the range of answers. So in these graphs, you see the range of answers given by humans versus the LLMs for all these games. And you can see that humans gave a wide range of answers, whereas the LLMs gave answers that were much more concentrated in a narrow band of options. So that's one big difference. All right, so that was a quick look at a paper that actually does administer sort of a Turing test to LLMs, and they pass, or at least GPT-4 passes. GPT-3 comes close. Or to be more precise, they are well within the statistical distributions that humans have on both personality traits and all these games like The Prisoner's Dilemma and so on. The interesting thing is that on these games, when they deviate from human behavior, thankfully, they are in a positive direction in that the LLMs are more altruistic and more cooperative than the average human. So LLMs pass the Turing test. That should be bigger news than it is, I guess. But I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please like the video, consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time. Thank you very much.